tricking, big tricks on all these hoes, paying for coochie, but want to come over here, wife me up. The fuck? Every time, it's this right here. Every motherfucker's time. Bitch, I'm trying to get tricked on too. Baby, I love the tricks. The fuck? Always want to, y'all like to bring the 2K to my house and move the fuck in. The fuck? What a bitch to cook for y'all and all that, baby. I wanna be a hoe too. The fuck, I miss being a hoe. I'm a retired hoe, bitch. I want to be a hoe for my nigga. So we gonna have to role play or something. Like, I like when a nigga call me up, come get this money. Yeah, daddy, I want some red bottles. Let me come work for it. Oh, you ready to suck on something? Yes, I am. Where the money at? Come, bitch, we gonna have to make it, like, put some spice in our motherfucking life, bitch. Cause I'm a wife, but bitch, I need to be a hoe wife. The fuck, and I don't give a fuck who judge me, cause y'all pussy ain't right, my bitch.
All right, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I would like to give all praise and glory and honor to Yahweh, Baha Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Baha Hashem, Racha HaKodash. I'm the brother Kasai Gadol from the Camp Province of Babylon, down here in Tampa, Florida, coming at you with a quick hit through the spirit and power of Yahweh Baha Hashem, Yahweh Shah. Double honor to the elders and apostles, a great millstone that taught me this truth and rule well, being great examples to us younger brothers. And peace, blessing, love, health, awareness, and all salutation to the hopeful elect, the house of David, that is scattered abroad across the four winds of the earth, that's laboring in his truth with all sincerity. Shalom and Baraka Thumb to the Akwath that are listening and learning in. Open to feed the lambs and the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Straight to the point, let's get to the lesson. All right, so I want to touch bases up on this clamorous, loudmouth-ass Jake, man. All right? And as you heard in the post-introduction video, and as you can still see, all right, this Evite right here, she's all in the camera talking about, she's just loud, she's clamorous. She's talking about how, you know, her box ain't like nobody else's. She don't care what nobody say. You know, so we just gonna jump right into the pre-sales that I drop. All right, I go on and I say, don't be like this dirty bitch. You see, don't be like this Eve, man. All right, the first pre-sub is Sirach, chapter 26, 22-23. It says, "And harlot shall be accounted as spittle, but a married woman is a tower against death to her husband." Right. So the Lord is saying that a harlot, which what is a harlot? A hoe, okay? A woman like this, she's showing her cleavage, all right? She got her pants unbuttoned. You can see her panty line, all right? She's showing her stomach. She got on this crop top type shirt that's basically her bra. You know, her titties about to pop out, okay? Our women are not supposed to be like this, man. But Babylon has given you women the okay and the authority to just sit here and feel as if you can wear, say, and do whatever it is that you want. But just like scripture say, pride goeth before destruction. All right. And that prideful ass spirit you eat, that this Evite got, her ass is going to eventually be destroyed. Because that same box that she's sitting up there beating on, going to be that same box that these men out here going to rape. Gonna rape her ass and take in that time of calamity, in that time of trouble, man. Verse 23, a wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man, but a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. Right. You see, it just said in the last pre-sale, a married woman is a tower against the death to her husband. Right. Just like how Proverbs 18 and 10 says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it and is safe. So if you have a married woman and a woman that is shamefaced, all right, she's in order, she's going to be a tower unto you. She's going to be peace unto you, okay? A woman is supposed to be a pillar of rest to her man, supposed to serve her man with all truth and sincerity, okay? But a woman like this, a wicked woman is given into a portion of a wicked man. So nobody, anybody else that sees this, they're going to be ready, or any Jake that sees this, he's going to be ready to jump down her throat, jump in her DMs, like, oh, I want to know what that box like, this, that, and the third. She talking about she ready to be tricked on, she like to be tricked on, that, and with her umbrellas on and all, man. That's completely going off. Our women are completely fucking destroyed, bro. Completely fucking destroyed. Verse 25, it says, a shameless woman shall be counted as a dog, but she that is shamefaced will fear the Lord. Right. And what is a dog? A bitch. A female dog is considered a bitch. So a shameless woman, a shamefaced woman, a shameless woman shall be counted as a dog, but she that is shamefaced will fear the Lord. Right. So if you shamefaced, all right, and to be shamefaced is to be humiliated. So if you understand your role and you understand the order, you're going to fear Yahweh by Shimei I was shot. And the Lord sees that as righteous, opposed to this damn Evite woman right here that's just loud as hell. She loud as hell, ain't saying nothing but a bunch of vexation, saying nothing but a bunch of wicked ass shit. Women like this don't be like this, sisters. Do not be like this woman here. That same pride is going to get your ass destroyed, raped, robbed, and murdered, man. Because of shit like this. Because these elites, they see that, man. These traffickers, they see this stuff. Anything you put on the internet is not, it's basically free game, man. It can be found. It can be traced. Hackers can trace and hack into anything, man. So they can find this woman, see this woman all on the streets. Like, oh, yeah, that's that one girl. That's that one Jake, you know what I'm saying? Or that one nigga woman that was all on the computer punching at her box loud as hell. Let's see how loud in hell she is now. She says she like to be tricked on. It's going to be the same bitch that's going to be sold into fucking prostitution because she love to be tricked on. She want to be tricked on. Nah, man. Verse 20. Salakia, verse 26. A woman that honoreth her husband shall be judged wise of all, but she that dishonoreth him in her pride shall be counted ungodly of all. And that's exactly what it is, man. She want to talk about, oh, niggas like to be tricking, doing this and doing that. Well, unfortunately, sister, it wouldn't be considered as tricking. Now, if a Jake out here paying a bitch for pussy when he don't have to do that, because the men are the prize, man. We the prize. You women were created to serve the man. So understand that. Get your ass in order or die. It's that simple, man. I'm going to grab this one quick pre-sub right quick. This is Proverbs chapter 9 and verse 13. A foolish woman is clamorous. She is simple and knoweth nothing. Right. And that's exactly what she is. She's a foolish woman and she's clamorous. And what does it mean to be clamorous? To be loud, to be obnoxious. All right. Who knows what time it was when she made the video? It could have been early in the morning. It could have been in the afternoon. It don't really matter. But that's the problem with Eve, man. She just feel like she has to be extremely loud because she wants to be heard. Don't nobody need to hear your ass. You are deprived from wisdom, man. Let's grab that, too. This is Job chapter 39 and verse 17. Because Yahweh hath deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding. Right, so these women out here, they don't have the same wisdom and knowledge and understanding that us men have, man. The true men of the Lord, all right? So you can't, excuse me, Salakia. You can't expect for a woman to get it on this side, unless you've already been dealing with this woman, all right, and she understands the order and she understands what you are in. But a woman like this Evite woman right here, Salakia, let's go back to the video. This Evite woman right here, she's not gonna get it, man. Look, she got her cumbrellas on, she all tatted up, she got that long hair, she just doing too fucking much, man. She doing too much. And she gonna be the same bitch that's gonna be sitting up there fucking hollering, screaming, crying for somebody to help her dumb ass in that time of Jacob's trouble, man. Because it's coming. What does it say in Habakkuk? The vision is yet for an appointed time, though it tarry, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not tarry, man. Jacob's trouble is not gonna delay. Jacob's trouble is not gonna wait. Jacob's trouble is coming, man. So you Evite women out there that wanna feel like you can absorb authority over men, you're going to get it, man. Let's go to this real quick. We're going to end it on this. Oops, Salakia. 1 Timothy chapter 2, starting at verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness and sobriety, and not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. Is she dressed in shame? Is she dressed modestly? No, she's not. She's showing all her damn cleavage and shit. You see? Her titties about to damn pop out of that last crop top. All right? She got her stomach all showing. When a woman, when a man gets it, what scriptures say, when a man getteth the wife, he beginneth the possession, a helpmate like unto himself. So once you become the possession of a man, should nobody else see your body besides your man? You see? So you should be dressed in shame, or you should be dressed in modest apparel and be shamefaced. So that you could be shamefaced, it goes back into humiliation. Because that's what it means. You're a female servant. And what does it mean to serve? To basically be, you have to be brought low. You have to be humiliated. Because before honor is humiliation, man. Reading on. But which becometh woman profession godliness with good works. Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. She ain't learning in silence. She want everybody to hear her damn mouth. And she ain't saying nothing. But a two-third woman, a woman without the understanding and the knowledge and the truth about the Bible, okay, without coming back to you, how about Shimei Arashai, she's going to look at this shit as if that's okay to do. So then she's going to go out and imitate this in a different way, but in her own fashion. You see, she may not be sitting up there punching at a box. She may sit up there and throw her ass in the camera. This OF shit and these private Snapchats, these fans only bull crap that you women like having, all that shit is about to be cut short. Unless you gonna take that chip. So I advise you to get rid of that pride and get yourself in order, or the Lord gonna do it for you, man. Verse 12. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to absorb authority over the man, but to be in silence. Right. So a woman out here shouldn't necessarily be teaching. This is how a woman should be. You don't be like this bitch right here. Don't do it. Don't be like her. Being like her is going to get you destroyed. Being like her may get you slapped in your face. Being like her, you could tell she's the type that she gets loud, clamorous, you know, obnoxious, you know, to a point where it's aggravating. And she's probably the type that feel like she can whoop a nigga ass. Salakia for my words. So let me rephrase that. She probably the type that she feels like she can beat up a man. And that's going to be the same type that's going, she's going to be the same type of woman she is the same type of woman that's going to be punched, raped, robbed, and murdered, man. Seeing that type of stuff, I'm sorry for my words, but seeing that type of stuff, man, really irks me, man. Because it's like our people are truly damn destroyed, man. Truly fucking destroyed. We're going to go on. We're going to go to this. And we're going to end it on this. Let's go over to Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast reject knowledge, I will also reject thee. That thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children. Right, man. Right. Our people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. If she had any type of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, she wouldn't be sitting up here all over damn social media the way she is right now. Just loud. And it looked like she drank a damn water in a wine glass. She just wants somebody that she, all they look for is the views, and they look for people to jump in their DMs, man. That's it. Once again, don't be like this bitch. Shalom, Yeshua'ella. I'm going to close out and give all praise and glory, honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh, Bahashem, Racha HaKodash, and double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone that taught me this truth and rule well. Peace, blessing, love, health, and all salutation to the hopeful elect. Shalom, DTA, Abba, Babal, soon.